في يوم وصفه ربنا عز وجل فقال عنه وفيه: يا أيها الناس، يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. اللهم قنا عذابك يوم تبعث عبادك يا رب العالمين. وبريز الله سبحانه وتعالى Lord the world, and we bear witness, there is no messenger, the final messenger is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and no one after him. He was a servant and the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he was the final messenger to all mankind and jinn. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace and blessing upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his household. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace and blessing upon all the sahaba rahimahum Allah alayhim and the followers and all of us, Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. My dearest and respected brothers and sisters, first and foremost, I would like to remind myself and remind you all with the first thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind all the creation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recommended for all the creation, for us and people before us. Allah Azza wa Jalla said in Surah An-Nisa, وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنْ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. We have recommended the people before you and you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dearest and respected brothers and sisters, my advice to you and my advice to myself first, to fear Allah Azza wa Jal. And may ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from those people Allah Azza wa Jal said, O you who believe, fear Allah Azza wa Jal the way you should be feared. And do not die except in the state of Islam. My dearest and respected brothers and sisters, today inshallah ta'ala will focus about two parts in the Quran Kareem. And these two related to one subject. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned to us all in the Quran Kareem in Surah Al-Tahrim one verse, but very important. But maybe we're not focusing on it. Maybe we don't listen to it the way we should listen. Are you ready? Ready to hear the verse? Allah said in Surah Al-Tahrim, verse number 6. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. وأهليكم نارا وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. الله سبحانه وتعالى talking to you and I, talking to all the believers, all the Muslims. He said, O you who have believed, protect yourself and protect your families from the fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the fuel for this fire the people and the stones. And the garden of this fire is very tough and strong engines. They never disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will do what Allah Ta'ala commanded them to do. So my dearest brothers and sisters, we are receiving the summer break. And it's good. It's fun. But in the same time, we must know that this period of time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us about it. In the hadith, the authentic hadith of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, this hadith narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi radiallahu anhu, عن أبي برزة الثعلبي. صحابي his name is أبي برزة الثعلبي. حضرت أبي برزة narrated that Rasulullah عليه الصلاة والسلام said, no foot will move in the hereafter before they will be asked about four things. First, about his age, what he had done in it. Second, specific period. About his youth, what he has done in it, and about his money, from where he got it and from where he spent it, and from his knowledge, what he did with it. Believe that Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam took into every one of us your life as a trust in your hand. You will be asked about it, what you had, what you did. In this period of life, how many years you lived in dunya, what you have done, what you done in your life. We have in the summer break, and this a great opportunity for everyone of us, especially for our youth, for our kids, to run to Allah Azza wa Jalla, to run to the Quran and Sunnah, to run to the Masjid, to run to the house of Allah Azza wa Jalla. How many times our kids spend their own time in the electronic devices? How many YouTubes they are watching? How many Islamic YouTubes they are watching? How many games they are spending their time on it? And how many minutes they spend on teaching, listening to Quran, following up with any sheikh. So my rule and your rule is protect ourselves and protect our families. As much as we are very concerned about our kids if they get hurt or if they had a fever, we run to doctors. We are very careful and concerned about their physical issue. But the most important for their own internal life, Jannah or Naar, we are heedless, we are busy. We cannot believe until we see something in our hand. I'm telling all my kids all the time, if you can bear the lighter in your finger, do whatever you want. No one can do it. Open lighter and put it under the finger. How long you can have it? Couple second. What about Allah Azza wa Jal tell us this news? Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Layl, فَأَنذَرْتُكُمْ نَارًا تَلَظَّى. I warn you. Fire. It's extremely ناراً تلظى لا يصلاها إلا الأشقى. So my dearest and respected brothers and sisters, fathers, mothers, the head of any household, you being responsible in front of Allah Azza wa Jal about your own kids, what you did to protect them from the fire. May Allah Azza save all of us from Hellfire, Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbi ameen. My brothers, the part of the Quran al-Kareem came to us in Surah Al-Ma'arij. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, at that day, يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَأَخِيهِ وَفَصِيلَتِهِ الَّتِي تُؤْوِيهِ ومن في الأرض جميعا ثم ينجيه. الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned to us that in the day of judgment, that every criminal, Allah said a criminal, يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ. Criminal. Why? Because he didn't do his job. Protecting himself and protecting his family. يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ. The criminal will wish if he can run away. And if he can save himself by replacing his kids, his wife, and all his entire tribe, even the whole people on earth. وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ يُنْجِيهِ. Surah Al-Ma'arij, verse number 6 to number 9. Another surah, Allah Ta'ala said, Surah Abasa wa Tawalla, Surah Abasa. What Allah Ta'ala said? فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةِ يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه. الله تعالى also giving us another view in Surah Abbas. Verse number 33 to 36. Allah said, when the day of judgment happened, a man will flee from his mother, from his dad, from his wife, from his brother, from his kids. Because every man at that day, he would be busy with his own business. Everyone say, I want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to be the one who been selected to paradise. So my dearest and respected brothers, again, listen to what Allah said in Surah Tahrim, verse number 6. O you who believe, protect yourself and protect your families from the fire. The fuel of this fire is the people and the stones. And one of the most important things to protect your families from fires is connect them with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Connect them with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by teaching them the book of Allah. Teaching them the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Take this summer as a opportunity. Take it as a big favor and focus with your own kids. Send them to the masajid. Let them go and have connection with the masjid. There is no school. How many kids here in the masjid? Where is the kids? There is no school. Our wives should come to the masjid. Because the most important teacher ever is the mother. Is the mother. And if the mother not coming to the masjid, from where she can live? Don't tell me from the TV. Or from any online course, because barely will happen. Yes, there is some. But compare it to how much they will spend in other stuff. So again, maybe we hear this many times. But do you know why, what is different between us and the Sahara? Sahara, when they hear any verse of the Quran al-Kareem, they will know it, that Allah talking to them. Anas radiallahu anhu Allah said, Sahaba radiallahu alayhim, if they was walking in the street of Medina, and if they heard anyone say, reciting Quran, for example, Ya ayuha alladhina amanu, they will stop and they will look to the sky. Yes, my Lord. Yes, my Lord. Because Allah calling them. Allah calling us. Who is the believer here? You and I. So Sahaba radiallahu alayhim used to know that. When they hear, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْفُوا بِالْعُقُودِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَحِلَّتْ لَكُمْ. When they hear any calling from Allah Azza Jal, they will look at the sky and say, yes, my Lord. And I listen, I'm obeying my Lord. But us, change the channel, we hear the Quran. Yeah, I love the Quran. Change, I have no time to hear it. Amal came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, O Messenger of Allah, I have such a disease. And it's bothered me so much. He said, what is that? He said, my heart become tough. My heart become tough. He said, what is the sign for your heart become tough? How do you know your heart is a tough? He said, because Ya Rasulullah, when I recite the Quran, I never cry. Allahu Akbar. He mentioned his complaint is, because when I recite the Quran, I never cry, because it's the word of Allah. Doesn't affect me. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, so mention the death. Put in your mind that you'll die sooner or later. Will make you not care about dunya. You'll focus in akhirah. If you know that you will die sooner or later, you will be busy by preparing your house for the next step. For example. Al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said, there was small island. And this island has very specific protocol for who will be the king. Their protocol is the first one will come from the shore, he will be the king. And this wise man, he was riding his boat. Suddenly, storm happened. His boat broken and the wave threw him to the shore. When he received the shore, he found people celebrating. Hey, we got our king! He said, who's the king? He said, you the king! He said, me the king? How come? He said, you are our king. Focus please. I'm talking to you. Important, wallah. Listen to the end. Take the most important in the end of the story. Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned it in his book called Al-Fawaid, which means the most important thing you can hear. He said, the man was very surprised. How I am the king? I'm no one. I just thrown in the shore. He said, no, because our protocol is in every time when we need to select the king, we'll wait for the first one came from the sea. And you are the first one. But you have to know that you will be the king only for 10 years. And after that, we take our king and we throw him in very bad desert. Nothing in it. What do you think he's going to do? He will be a king for 10 years. But after that, he will be thrown in a place Allah knows only how this place will look like. So this man, he was wise. He didn't get busy in the time he was a king, but he started to send a farmer, a construction people to make a farm and build houses in this desert. They used to throw people in it. By the end of the 10 years, having, they came with big celebrations, they would throw him in their mind, in the desert. Ard Falah. And they find him happy. He said, how come? For everyone before you, when this time came to throw him out, he would be crying and say, no, give me another day, give me another week, give me another. But you are happy. He said, the answer you will know it when you come to throw me. When they were carrying him to go, they look for the desert. There is no desert. Become a garden, houses, people working. He said, where is our desert? Where is the place we used to throw people? He said, I learned the lesson from people before me. So I didn't get busy with the 10 years, but I worked for what after the 10 years. Do you know who is a king? You and I. Our 10 years in the dunya and our entire life when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you think you'll be busy in this 100 years in dunya? And when you become close to die, to wish, رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِ like what Allah said in Surah Al-Mumun, حَتَّى إِذَا حَضَرَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتُ قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ كَلَّا إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ أو كما قال الله عز وجل. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وزد بارك عليه وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى صحابته الغر المامين. رضى اللهم عنا معهم جميعا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. My dearest and respected brothers and sisters, the main point of this khutbah is take the advantage of summer and connect yourself and your kids to the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Listen to what Allah said. And this is what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith. In the authentic hadith of Rasulullah عليه الصلاة والسلام said, كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. Every one of you as a shepherd for his family. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى will ask him what he did to his family. So my dearest and respected brothers, take the advantage of summer time and come to the masjid, connect the Quran, send your kids to Islamic schools. You are responsible about them, as you are responsible for feeding them, clothing them, taking them to the doctors. You are responsible to feed their spiritual needs and to fill their iman and to strengthen their faith. May Allah Azza wa Jalla strengthen our faith and may Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala strengthen our iman. يا أيها الإخوة الأكارم، الله سبحانه وتعالى ذكر لنا في كتابه الكريم مواضع عديدة، والأمر الذي ينبغي علينا أن نستحضره جيدا وأن نضعه في أذهاننا هو أمر الله لنا بأن نحفظ أنفسنا وأن نحفظ أولادنا وعائلاتنا من النار التي وعد الله عز وجل بها عباده المكذبين. هذه النار قال الله عز وجل عنها: وقودها الناس والحجارة. فيا أيها الإخوة الأكارم، أنا وأنت مأمورون بأن نحفظ أولادنا وذرياتنا. كيف نحفظهم؟ بأن نلزمهم بكتاب الله تعالى، أن نعلمهم سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، أن نربط أولادنا بمساجدنا. ورحم الله من قال: وينشأ ناشئ الفتيان منا على من كان عوده أباه، وينشأ ناشئ الفتيان منا على ما كان عوده أباه. إن عودت ولدك على الحضور إلى المساجد وأن يستمع إلى القرآن ويستمع إلى حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سينشأ في هذا الجو. أما إن كان ولدك ملهو طول النهار على الفيديو جيمز، وما أدراك ما الفيديو جيمز؟ ماذا تنتظر منه في المستقبل؟ يا أيها الإخوة الأكارم، وقال الله عز وجل لنا جميعا: فأنذرتكم نارا تلظى لا يصلاها إلى الأشقى. يا أيها الإخوة الأكارم، ذكر الله لنا حالنا يوم القيامة، نحن الضعفاء إلى الله عز وجل، حالنا جميعا يوم القيامة حين نفر من أبنائنا وبناتنا ونفر من زوجاتنا وأمهاتنا وآبائنا. قال الله: يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه. لماذا رب؟ لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغني. كل يقول نفسي نفسي، حتى أنبياء الله تعالى، حتى يأتينا حبيبنا صلى الله عليه وسلم فيقول: يا رب لا أسألك فاطمة ابنتي ولا صفية عمتي، ولكن أسألك أمتي أمتي أمتي. فيجيبه الله تعالى: إنا سنرضيك في أمتك. يا محمد ارفع رأسك وسل تعطى واشفع تشفع، فإنا لن
نخذلك في أمتك بأبي وأمي صلى الله عليه وسلم. إنا سنرضيك في أمتك. يا أيها الإخوة الأكارم، البدارة البدارة والمسارعة المسارعة إلى أن نأتي إلى بيوت الله تعالى، وأن نلزم أولادنا بالقرآن الكريم والمدرسة الإسلامية وبتعليم هذا الدين العظيم. من يعلم أبناءنا إن لم نعلمهم في بيوتنا؟ أسأل الله تعالى أن يحفظ عليكم أبناءكم ويديم عليهم وعلينا نعمة الإيمان والهداية. اللهم إنا نسألك ربنا رب كل شيء ومليكه أن تغفر ذنوبنا. اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا، اللهم يسر أمورنا، اللهم اشرح صدورنا. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة، ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم آلنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وآلنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما أنت به أعلم، إنك أنت الله العزيز الأكرم. اللهم كل إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم كل إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم كل إخواننا في جنين وفي غزة يا رب العالمين، وفي كل مكان فيه مسلم مستضعف يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر من نصر الدين، اللهم انصر من نصر الدين، اللهم انصر دينك وكتابك وسنة نبيك وعبادك الصالحين. هذا وصلوا وسلموا على رسول الله وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين.